AI-driven augmented analytics now uses natural language processing technology from Ask Data, which SAP acquired in 2022 and has integrated into SAP Analytics Cloud. Users can access the new feature enabling natural language queries from their homepage and will be able to visualize their query results in tables. The use of large language models, or LLMs, improves the accuracy and consistency of answers compared to existing search-driven offerings. SAP plans to unveil more conversational chatbot-like interactions capabilities, allowing users to receive query results from traditional databases augmented by certified knowledge content.
Hey everybody, Josh Bentley, developer advocate. There are tons of announcements coming out of this week's Sapphire conference in Orlando. But for this audience, I wanted to highlight three things that are relevant to all developers as we continue learning on behalf of ourselves and the companies that we work for. First, we have SAP S/4HANA Cloud Public Edition courses on learning.sap.com. I've referred you to other courses and learning journeys in the past, most recently the SAP BTP Kima learning journey, but this is a new offering for SAP S/4HANA Cloud Public Edition on the SAP Learning site. These are the first ERP-focused learning journeys to be published on this page, and they're free of charge. The next item I wanted to bring your attention to was that we now have made the SAP Learning Hub the gateway to a reinvented premium digital learning experience for subscribers. We still offer tons of free learning resources to help upskill the millions of SAP users, developers, analysts, you name it. But also with the SAP Learning Hub, we will have an entry point to access an expanding list of reimagined premium services in a new digital learning experience. It's available only to subscribers. You may want to practice coding on your own or have an interaction with an instructor. SAP Learning Hub subscribers will be able to seamlessly access multiple different types of resources in this one place. Lastly, I wanted to highlight the announcement that we are introducing a role-based certification for enterprise architects. Lots of our SAP customers utilize the job role of enterprise architect, and with this certification, someone can follow the path to become an SAP enterprise architect with an understanding of the solutions, business, and strategic aspects of enterprise architecture. For more information on this item, visit the SAP Certification for Enterprise Architect page, and be sure to see all the announcement links in this video description about all the great things that have come out of SAP Sapphire this week.
At Sapphire this week, SAP announced new SAP Build capabilities to continue to more fully integrate SAP Build into other key SAP products. SAP Build Process Automation can now subscribe to business events and SAP applications via the Advanced Event Mesh service of SAP Integration Suite. So for example, an event like a new employee starting can automatically trigger an SAP Build Process Automation workflow. With also, processes built with SAP Build Process Automation can now be triggered from SAP Signavio automatically. At TechEd last year, this was a beta feature, but now it is generally available. An SAP Business Accelerator Hub, the evolution of SAP API Business Hub, will now contain even more pre-built content, including SAP build content, such as bots and processes. Just as now, this SAP build content will also be available in the SAP lobby. In addition, at Sapphire, there were scheduled to be demos of integrating the SAP build tools with ABAP and accelerating development in CAP using ChatGPT.